Hello students, today we will learn how to write notice. Notice actually it's not something new for you because notice we have done in our previous classes also. And let us revise it then. The very first thing you should know, why do we use notice? Why do we write notice? So I have already told you in your class. Once again, let me tell you, notice is a small piece of information which we write to tell something to large group of people. Suppose you want to tell something to one of your friend or one of your teachers, you write personal letter or something, you write and tell them, you message them and inform them. But if there is any information which you want to tell whole school or whole class or maybe in any organization, they want to tell it to their employees and so many people together. So it's better to write notice so that everybody can read it. These notices are generally put on the notice board. You must have seen that we also have notice board in our school, and all the notice whatever comes, we have new notice, we put it on the notice board. So that is the use of notice writing, which is very important for you also for your class 12th, and it is of 4 marks. It comes of 4 marks in your question paper. So let us start it. The very first thing which we have to keep in mind before writing notice is we have to write notice inside the box. So box, as you know, when you draw the box, you have to draw 3 lines and you don't have to close it, because notice may be, you can write it in more lines, and if you close it for all four sides first, you will not be able to write it correctly. So very first thing, we make a box, and at the top of the notice, the very first thing which you have to write, that you have to write institution's name. Institution's name can be the school name, can be any company name. For which company or school you are writing your notice, it's written in the picture also. You can see issuing authority and agency. So which, like if you are writing notice, suppose you want to give any information of any competition, suppose you want to give information to students to for your inter house dance competition. So what will you do? First you will write your school name, General B.C. Joshi Army Public School, and after that, right hand side, your right hand side, you will write date, and date should not be written in slash or dash. I have already told you in the class, it should be written full. Wednesday 19th of May 2016 is written, like but you will write the day in which day you are writing the notice, and after that you can write it in the same line also, notice in capital letter, notice in capital letter. Next line, then you have to write heading. Heading should be, you will not simply write, if you are talking about dance competition, simply don't write dance competition. The heading should be eye-catching and in the bold. Why it should be eye-catching in the bold? Because when we see the notice board, there may be so many notices. It happens like when you read the newspaper. There are hundreds of thousands of news in the newspaper. We don't have so much of time to read every news there. So which news you read it carefully, whose headlines or the heading you like it, then you feel like, okay, this is interesting and I have to read it. So same thing happens to notice writing also. When you put notice in the notice board, you have to write eye-catching heading so that the people, those who read notice, they see it and they read your whole notice. After that, body of the notice, when we talk about, there are 3 important W's. W. The very first one is what, when, and where. These 3 things are very important when you write notice. What, when, and where. So when you start writing, suppose generally children start, like, all the students of class 6 to 12th are informed that what is there? There is inter-house dance competition. When, then you will write date, and where you will write the venue. So www, what, when and where, that's very important, that you should not forget, whether it is given in the question or not, but these things you have to write. These three things are very important. Other than that, you can add other information also, what, when and where. After that, you can add your information which you want to give. If you want to give any prize money, if you want to tell about the judges, you, it depends on you, how do you want to write. But these things, three things are very important. And in other than that, you can also include other information which you want, but it should not exceed more than 50 words. It should not exceed more than 50 words. And how do we count the words? When we count the words, we do not count preposition and conjunction and articles. Word should be words, English word, when you count it. So it should not exceed more than 50 words. Suppose this all information is given in the question, so you have to copy everything. Whatever is given in the question, you have to write everything. You cannot skip anything or you cannot leave everything. Every information, every piece of information which is given in the question, that is must to write in the notice. And if you have word limit left, you can write more words. So then you can include other information too. And at last, when you write this body of the letter, when all the students are informed that this competition is on date and where, and you give the other information to whatever you wish to write. After that, at last, the last line should be, for further information, contact undersigned. For further information, contact undersigned. Undersignment, first thing you have to write, you have to do your signature, then should be your name, then should be your designation. Signature, name and designation. Now, maybe in some of the question, name is already given, so you have to copy the same name. If name is not given, then you have to write your name. And for designation also, if designation given in the question, then you write the same designation. If suppose it is not given, then you can write your own designation, like activity in charge or class monitor, etc., etc. Okay. So this sequence should not change. Signature, name, designation. Don't write name first or signature after that. It should be signature, name and designation. And don't forget to put the notice inside the notice box. And after writing this, you close the notice. Notice can be of different type. This notice I have told you about the competition. They can be lost and found also. They can be you are going in any excursion or tour also. There are so many types of notice, and the way of writing them, the language will be different, but the format will remain same. So you have to follow the same format, and the important thing is eye-catching heading should be there. Like dance competition, simply don't write dance competition. It can be let's dance, dance, APCS dance, and think of any eye-catching heading which will attract the people to read your notice. And you already know it how to write. So if you have any confusion and you want to ask any question, you may ask it. I'll give you two questions to do in your copy and I'll send it in your group.